ब्रह्मदर्शनम् ब्रह्मदर्शनम् सत्यदर्शनम् आत्मदर्शनम् मीन्स् नोयिङ्ग् द सेल्फ् टु नो गाड् यु हव् टु नो दि सेल्फ् रैट् नौ वि आर् ट्रैङ्ग् टु नो गाड् विदौट् नोयिङ्ग् अवर् सेल्फ् ओके इफ् यु नो युवर् सेल्फ् यु नो गाड् आल्सो बिकास् गाड् ईस् युवर् सेल्फ् हैयर् सेल्फ् अदर्स् यु हव् ओन्लि कान्सेप्ट्स् आफ् गाड् conceptual God, not a reality. The reality is, He is your Self. So that is called Brahmadarshanam. Knowing God is called Brahmadarshanam. God is called Brahman. Brahmadarshanam is called Satyadarshanam. That is truth. Okay? God is truth, Satyam. Imagine you are going in an outer space, in a rocket. Okay. Sun is behind you. Do you see light outside? Divya? No? What do you see?
Sun is behind you, right? Yes, you'll be able to see.
You'll see the shadow? What do you see? What do you see in front?
Wherever the light is
falling.
See anything.
Yeah, sun is?
Back,
above, back. Just behind that. And in front, do you see light or darkness?
Light.
Darkness.
You will not see a single ray of light in front of you. You will not see shadow also. Because sunlight in the outer space doesn't have any obstruction. If obstruction is there, the sunlight gets reflected and you see the sunlight. You are able to see sunlight on the earth because earth is obstructing, reflecting surface. Okay? In outer space, there's not even dust particle. The outer part, outer space is full of darkness, even though you stand in front of the sun. Behind, sun is behind you. If you see behind sun, you can see. Look in front, sun is not there. Light, darkness. Okay?
We may abstract, but the light comes.
The light comes, but the light you cannot see. Because light requires a obstruction. That obstruction is not there. If you put a mirror there, you can see the sun, light. But in the outer space, there's nothing. It's all emptiness. Not even a particle of dust is there. That's why you can't see the light. It's only darkness, even though you're standing in front of the sun. Clear? Anybody has a doubt?
Suppose a meteorite or something comes, it'll...
So you can see a meteorite,
yeah.
Because of obstruction.
Yeah,
but otherwise, a meteorite also very, very small in the outer space. Its space is infinite. So you see infinite darkness, somewhere you see some small meteorite or some light or star. Otherwise, you see total darkness in the outer space.
It is not bright there for
the... You have to use a torchlight. Within the spacecraft, you have to use the light. The outer space is completely darkness. You understand? Divya? You have doubt about that?
No, I'm just trying to
digest. See, here, even our sky appears blue. Because the dust particles in the sky are scattering the light.
Mm-hmm.
If the dust particles are not, there's no blueness also. So, you're able to see the light in the earth. Because sunlight is, earth is obstructing sunlight. Otherwise, there's no sunlight you cannot see. It's transparent. Okay? So, I told you, sun, because replace sun with Atma. Okay? Brahman, Atma, both mean same thing. Self or, not self in the sense, small self, transcendental self, it's called Brahman. When I use the word self, you have to always take the word self as bigger, capital self, which is transcendental self. It's called Brahman. Okay? The self is like sun. Like sunlight is everywhere, the self, the light of the self is everywhere. The light of the self is called Atmajyothi. Understand? That is the name of the foundation chai given. Light of the self foundation. It's everywhere, but you cannot see it. The light. It requires an obstructing surface. Are you getting what I'm saying? Okay. Now, what is the obstructing surface for Atma? Because Atma is Satya, eternal truth. Nothing other than Atma is there. Nothing else is there other than Atma. Right? So, if nothing else is there other than Atma, then where is the obstructing surface?
The body is the obstructing surface.
Body cannot be there, no, without Atma. See, in Atma, there is no body, nothing is there. Because Atma alone is there. There is non-dual. There is no other. You understand? No other is nothing is there. No other thing is there. Nothing else can be there other than Atma. Then where did the body come into picture?
Some imagination. That imagination created the obstruction.
The now Atmas imagine some bodies. The Atma has a power of imagination. Okay? The power of imagination is called Maya Shakti of Atma. Okay?
Then what we are seeing around us?
Who sees and who sees? Last class, your Drashya Viveka is there? You attended 3 seers?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, good.
Seer 1, seer 2, seer 3. Who is seeing? Who is seer? Seer number 3, seer number 2, seer number 1. Remember that?
Yes.
Who is seer number 1?
Body.
No. Seer number 3, seer number 1 is eyes. Seer number 2 is mind. Seer number 3 is?
Atma.
Then who is the seer? Everything else is a concept, which is again created by Atma. Arising in Atma. The real seer is Atma only. Remember Divya? Okay. So now, the seer and hearer is Atma only. There is a surface which is required for reflecting light, and that surface is called mind. Okay, so the mind is shown as a mirror here. You can see here. Can't I tell you? This mirror. So this is Atma. Okay, Atma is the sun, like sun. The light from Atma is called Atmajyothi. Okay, it is falling on a mirror called mind, and there is nothing can be mirrored by there in consciousness. So the consciousness creates a concept called mirror, mind, concept, and this called concept, this way is called Maya. From our point of view, it appears to be real. From consciousness point of view, it's still a concept. Are you getting what I'm saying? So the mirror reflects the sunlight maximum. The stone reflects less, water reflects less. Like that, these mirrors are of three types: sattva-guna, rajoguna, tamoguna. Okay? So buddhi is the mirror, buddhi or the intellect of all living beings is the finest mirror. It's made up of sattva-guna. Okay? Understand? Sattva guna is the finest quality which reflects Atma fully. So if Atma is Shiva, reflection of Shiva is called Shakti. Okay? Atma is unmanifest, unborn, and it appears to be born in the form of Shakti. The reflection of consciousness, the first reflection of consciousness is called Shakti. Is that so much clear? Clear, sir? And reflection happens in the mind. Pure mind. The pure mind is called Buddhi. You don't have to make your mind pure. Already pure mind is there. Okay? Only dust is accumulated. Other dust. The deep inside this pure mind is there. That's why God is reflecting on that. If this mind is impure, the God cannot reflect there. Right? You don't have to purify your mind to get God. Already God is reflecting the pure mind. You have to go there.
You mean intellect,
intellect. Subtle intellect. Purified intellect. The intellect gets corrupted. Intellect then comes Rajoguna and Tamoguna comes into picture, which will corrupt a part of the intellect.
Pure intellect
light means satoguna.
Satoguna.
100%
satoguna.
But still it is a guna.
It's guna. Guna is guna because it's not there actually. It appeared in Maya.
Yeah, but still it is appearance is there.
It appears there.
You can't say no mind. You can't say no mind.
No
it is
mind
there,
you can
but
no,
it is in a subtle.
No mind you can say only when you realize Atma.
In a subtlest way you can say.
Yeah. Is that clear? Okay. So that first reflection of God is called Shakti. And first reflection appears in you as I am. Do you feel I am? Is the feeling of I amness in you? When you wake up in the morning, first thing that I am feeling comes up. Then body appears. Then the world appears. Do you notice that sequence?
That I am is independent of the body mind.
It's a reflection on the, it is independent on the sattva-guna.
No, okay, but it doesn't identify with the body mind.
No, it doesn't.
At the moment.
It doesn't appear. Okay, so you're like you boot up your computer, first some signal symbol comes. Like you boot up your body, when you deep sleep, you wake up. Deep sleep, you are the Atma only. Okay, you means mind. Wake up, first I am thought comes. I am feeling comes. Then body comes. Then the world comes. Which comes first? Which comes last? What is the sequence?
That we are
talking.
That I am waking up then.
I am. Waking also, just I am comes. Okay, then comes the body. Then comes the world. It may happen in a fraction of a second, but that is the sequence. Right? That first feeling of I am is called Shakti. She is called Jagan Mata. Universal Mother. Jagan Mata appears and creates your body and the world for you to experience. Okay. In Sanskrit, that I am feeling is called aham. Okay. Aham feeling comes. It's not aham is not ahankara. Ahankara is a corruption of aham. No, I am feeling he is the Jagan Mata, not one aspect. I'll tell you why. I know why you are asking question. Because why Jagan Mata? Jagan Mata comes in all beings, you say. It's not like that. Jagan Mata appears in all beings and as I am only. Okay, in you she appears as I am, aham. Okay, without Jagan Mata appearing in you, you cannot see the world. There's no world. She has to give you consciousness. She gives you consciousness in the form of I am. Okay? And I am in Sanskrit is called aham. Second. Aham. Okay. Aham is in Sanskrit. A is akara. Ham is the last structure of Sanskrit. A, A, E, E. Up goes to ham. Okay? So, akara to hakara includes all alphabets of Sanskrit. In English, if I have to say, it means A to Z in English. What is A to Z in English for you? Everything. Where? Everything where? Everything what you experience is aham, which means Jagan Mata. In Sanskrit, they don't give the name just like that. That aham means Jagan Mata. Aham also means Ishwara, the Lord. So the Lord appears to show everything in the world. That's why it's called aham. Understand? If the Lord doesn't come, the system doesn't operate. And the Lord or Jagan Mata, Lord is, in Vedanta is called Ishwara, in Purana is called Shakti. The Shakti enters in the form of Aham. What is that?
That consciousness reflects on the mirror, which is a pure mind. And Sattva-guna reflects consciousness.
Fully. Yes.
That when you hear you are saying that,
No, not your open eyes. First feeling comes is aham. You don't have body, don't have concept of body also.
Aham. You wake up. Comes out.
Connect what? Connect what and what?
The pure mind. And this aham. What is the link?
No. The pure mind is like a mirror.
No.
Right?
It reflects consciousness. That is in me.
The reflected the me has not come in. Me has not yet come. What you call me is the body.
Okay.
That has not come. Before coming of the body, the boot operating system has to come. The booting. Mm-hmm. That booting is aham feeling. Aham feeling is Jagannamata. Jagannamata doesn't say aham. Aham. Aham is Jagannamata. You understand? So now that aham appears as many, many things, all the things in the world. First thing it appears as a body, as your body.
Yes.
Okay? Then other things in the world is seen. You understood?
That means, other things don't exist at all. There are no mountains.
We'll come to that. You're on the right track, but we'll come to that. So, the world is appearing from inside out, not outside in. The Jagannamata sits inside and shows the world outside. The world is not outside, Jagannamata is, I am not seeing it. It's because of Jagannamata, I am seeing the world outside. The world is in Jagannamata.
This world, does it exist? That's the question.
At the end of this, you tell me the answer. I'll take you through. Okay. So, have you understood what I am saying so far? Right? Now, me has not come. The first me has not come. Pure intellect has come. It's called Sattva Guna. In the pure intellect, I am feeling has come, which is Jagannamata. The mind is just inert. It has no capability.
Mm. Okay.
Now, it has become alive because of the
I am feeling.
Mm. This I am feeling itself is Jagannamata.
Mm.
Okay? In the sense that in Sanskrit, it's called aham. Means akara to hakara, everything in the universe is me. A to Z is me. The first thing which appears out of that is called your body. Then, husband, wife, family, the building, world appears. From aham. Aham is like your boot software. Equivalent of your boot software of Bhagavan. Okay? It contains A to Z. So now, the world is there, the body is there, but experiencer is required. If the without experience, the world is not anything. So that aham picks up one body, which is your body, and says, I am the experiencer of this world. It does through everybody, every body. Your body is picked up by the aham to experience the world in your viewpoint. it experiences the world in infinite viewpoints. Like a fish, like a monkey, everything. But from you, as your viewpoint.
Fish to me is a fish to them also.
Hmm?
What I see as that mountain, other also sees as mountain.
Not necessarily. Do you think fish sees a mountain?
No, I'm not talking about fish. Huh? Other human, for example.
They look at the world in their own way. You think they are looking at the world in your own way. Your vasanas and your impressions will make you to look the world in different ways. So there are two parts to that. What is appears and what you experience. They are different.
What we interpret
is different. Okay. Let us say a morning we open the door. One beautiful cow is standing in front of your house door. So what do you say?
Lakshmi has come
and you do puja. Okay. The same cow stand in front of somebody else's door. He says afternoon food. Okay. Interpretation goes on differently. Each person's mind differently. And same cow stands in front of a child. He sees the milk to drink. Same cow stands in front of a businessman. He sees the money. Okay? We color the world interpretation through our sense organs. And each person and each living being sees the world in a different way. A bat doesn't see the world as you see. A dolphin sees the world in a different way. A dog sees the world in a different way. The world depends on the seeing ability. So a person without eyesight, he cannot see the world. He can hear it. If your hearing is not there, then he cannot experience the world as you do. Sir, understood? So the consciousness experiences the world in infinite ways, through infinite beings. One of the ways is through your body. Okay? Clear? And it says, I am the body. And who has taken the form of I am the body? Shiva has taken the form of Shakti. Shakti takes the form of Jiva and the world. So Shiva has taken the form of Jiva and starts experiencing the world. Jiva remembering Shiva nature makes him free. Shiva is Jiva, Jiva is Shiva. Both equations we have forgotten. Shiva is Jiva and Jiva is Shiva, we have forgotten. Mm-hmm. Equations doesn't exist in our dictionary. Mm-hmm. Okay? That is meant by Tattvamasi, you are that. Jiva is the Shiva. Understood? Everybody's clear now so far? This first reflection of consciousness called reflected consciousness or Chidabhasa. Okay? And this is called I am, which is called Jagan Mata, it's called Aham. And that Aham takes Akara. What is Akara?
Form.
Akara means form. How many Akara? All Akaras. So one Akara it takes and experiences life. It's called Ahankara, which is called Jiva. That's called ego. Ego is not Aham. Aham takes the form of ego. Is it clear?
Aham is same and Ahankara is different. Like same I am taking the form of different things.
Yes.
Different I am.
Yes.
A different I am.
No. I am is same. One day I am. Mm-hmm. But that I am takes various forms.
So when it identifies with the form, then we call it Ahankara.
Yes. See what is happening is in spiritual books, all these are confused terminologies. Okay, they mix up, mess, they make a mess out of that. They don't understand what is really happening. Aham is Jagannatha or Ishwara. That's why it is said that Ishwaraha Sarva Bhutana Hridi Arjuna Tishtati. Shri Krishna tells Arjuna, Ishwara in the heart of all living beings. This is not physical heart, this is spiritual heart. Spiritual heart is called Buddhi. Pure Buddhi, and that is here, the cavity which I told you.
Pure Buddhi
is already there in you, you don't have to make it purified. Okay, that Aham appears there, then there is some, then other part of the Buddhi which is the Rajoguna and Tamoguna will come into picture to show you the world. Is that clear for all of you?
Tishtasi means he sits here.
He cannot sit or stand anywhere because he is always, right? He has no chair. He has to create a seat. The seat is the mind, mirror. And he, when he says sit, it not literally meaning sitting. That reflection on that is called sitting.
Omnipresent,
but for you, he is present there only.
Present in the mirror.
Present here. In the cavity. Okay, now what will happen? So the aham, the moment the mirror becomes alive, the consciousness doesn't have thoughts. The mind generates starting thoughts. The mind is like a bulb or electricity or fan. When the electricity passes, the fan starts rotating. So the mind becomes active now. It starts creating thoughts. So the first thought, aham thought will come because of the mind, not because of the consciousness, Chidabhasa. But Chidabhasa associated with that. So that says aham, I am. Okay. The next thought comes, the next reflection happens on the body. Body appears and the world appears. secondary reflection is the body, tertiary reflection is the world through sense organs. So immediately this I am catches hold of this body and says I am body for experiencing. Is it clear, sir? So in reality I am not the body. Body is secondary reflection. The primary source is here. I. Right? But can anybody see I? Can mind see I? No, nobody can see I. Okay? It's invisible source of light. It's like asking, is the bulb can see electricity? Can never see electricity. Right? So bulb, light, electricity comes and a bulb blows and sees, oh, this room. It says, I am the light. Okay? There's no light for the bulb actually. There's only one light, Atmajyothi, that gets reflected in the mirror and that gets reflected in the board and reflected in the body. Is that clear?
This is still now you are telling about only reflection part. No identification is involved.
No. It reflection and identification simultaneously happen. It reflects to the body and I am body and that identification happens and the world is seen. No, that's only mind now, pure mind.
Pure mind. So next stage only it identifies with that, oh, I am this body,
yes.
I am this mind, this
right.
Is mind.
So the mind has three gunas, sattva guna, rajo guna and tamo guna. Okay, rajo guna is activity, tamo guna is dullness, sattva guna is purity. In the purity, I am feeling comes. Rajo guna creates thoughts, means projects the world. Tamo guna immediately makes you forget that it's coming from sakshi. The light is coming from sakshi, it will make you forget. It's forgetfulness. Rajoguna shows the world and Tamoguna blocks, makes you forget that I am coming from the consciousness. Okay? So now what will happen? You have forgotten where is the source and you identify with the destination.
So the only that thing comes out.
That comes out. Okay?
So definitely that reflection and identification, but it depends one after another.
For explaining purpose, I am telling you sequentially.
Oh, okay.
It happens in no time actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
There is no time, but definitely there is a possibility that there can be a reflection without identification. Possibility.
Yeah, that's what is meditation.
Meditation.
You are stopping the identification through meditation.
But reflection still is there. Like
reflection is there. Without reflection, you will not be able to find out anything. No. Reflection is not there. Who? Brahman can't find himself. You cannot find.
Reflection is there means I am is there.
The I am feeling will be there. So that's why the meditation means I am feeling will be there. Okay? You stay in I am. There are no thoughts, means no world, no body. Okay? It is full awareness. But as if you are in deep sleep. In deep sleep, that I am feeling also disappears. But in meditation, that I am feeling will be there as if you are fully aware. Okay, but the world is not there. Okay, this I am feeling is reflecting Brahman or consciousness fully. Reflection.
That is in meditation. But when that full realization comes, in that also that I am.
No. This is first stage of meditation. Right now, stay there. Right? What will happen future, I'll tell you. Okay? So you have to become, by staying in I am, a feeling, then what will happen? Your vasanas will reduce. I am the body, catching up that I am the body will come down. Rajoguna and Tamoguna will start coming down.
But how can there be I am without body and thoughts?
No, I am is there, the mind is there, no, subtle mind is there.
I am
no.
Must be also thought only.
No, subtle mind is there, no, the buddhi is there, no, pure buddhi is there. Pure buddhi is not destroyed, reflecting surface is not destroyed. Reflecting surface, pure buddhi gets destroyed only in Videha Mukti. Parinirvana.
Map it with thoughts. I mean, is it also thought? I am is a thought.
I am is a thought.
I am is a thought of sattvic.
No. Sattva guna gives a reflection.
Okay.
Rajo guna part of that buddhi starts giving I am thought.
So, first
I am is pure reflection.
Pure reflection. And then second, you are telling it's a thought. And third, you are telling the identification, that forgetfulness, that I am pure thought.
That's the sequence. So in meditation, you are reducing the thoughts, even I am thought will go. That's a reflection is there. You are staying in that reflection gradually. Okay, without thoughts being coming up, the rajoguna will come down now. You are fully aware, alert, but I am thought also disappears. Thought is coming from rajoguna. You are staying in the pure reflection. Okay? Is that clear to everybody? Clear? Clear to all of you? Okay, so this much you understood? Now you see, this all happens in no time. There is no time here. What can happen? Okay? But for your clarification only, for understanding only, I have told in some sequence. Right? So there are three things we are speaking of. I am body means what? Jiva, individual, one who is suffering. Right? Sorry?
Sir, one thing. This is what you told, no? That is this first reflection, that is I am reflection. The second you told that I am is reflect on the body. Okay? So then, this is Jiva, what you told.
Now Jiva is actually a combination of these two, Chidabhasa and pure Buddhi, mind. The combination of this is called Jiva.
Okay. So when that reflected consciousness, no, that I am, is projected on the mind, that is, it identifies with the mind, then it becomes a Jiva.
Jiva.
So it is identification, no? It's not again there is a reflection on the, from the reflection of the mind on reflection on the body, like you are showing here, the reflection on the body.
Yeah.
So that body now becomes the Jiva.
No. Body doesn't become Jiva. The Jiva catches hold of the body.
Jiva
identifies with the body. Body is not Jiva. The body is dropped. And Jiva takes another body also, like that.
There is only one reflection, there is no second reflection.
Why second? No second reflection
is good. No reflection, no second reflection.
What is second reflection?
The first reflection, what you told is that when this consciousness is reflected on the pure intellect or mind.
Buddhi, yeah.
So, but second, what you told that it is again reflected on the body, and body it identifies with the body.
Right.
So, there is second reflection also.
Yes. So, the light from here. Okay, now creates more thoughts now.
Okay.
The more thoughts are appearing as a body.
Okay, so it is reflected on the
body. And the body becomes alive. And through sense organs of the body, the world is seen.
So it's an imagination layer. Body.
So body becomes imagination alive layer, and then we identify with the body. So first that reflection has to happen, and then only that identification can. Simultaneously.
It's all simultaneous, but for your explanation purpose, I'm telling like that. Shall you go further?
Then again world.
Huh?
Again world.
Again world appears, no? Sense organs, he opens the eyes and light goes to the world. Okay?
This third.
Third. Is my clear? So now, you say, I am eating. Who is really eating? I am eating is thought. Who is really eating?
The body is actually functioning.
Okay, shake.
Reflected consciousness.
Suresh, reflected consciousness. Who is eating? Who is digesting? Who is thinking? Who is knowing?
Shakti.
And you confuse it to the body. Yadevi.
Sarvabhuteshu
Shudharupena
Samsthita.
Means? No. Shudha means hunger. I am hungry. Who is hungry? The hunger is coming from Chidabhasa. I am. Jaganmata says, I am hungry. Through Jiva she eats. Yadevi
Sarvabhuteshu
Shudharupena
Samsthita
Namastasi
Namastasi
Namo
Namaha.
Means when you say I am hungry, if you say I am body, the body is nothing, it's a dummy. The hunger is expressed through your body, through the Chidabhasa, Jagatmata. Okay? That's why you can be hungry, dog can be hungry, monkey can be hungry. The hunger is universal, it's not individual. Got it? The same Jagatmata present in all, it's a universal function.
Okay.
Not individual. Mm-hmm. But you say, I am hungry. But your hunger and monkey's hunger is a difference. Monkey gets hungry and it eats a banana. But you need a chipset, chip or Maggie noodles. Mm-hmm. That's your vasana. Specific. Hunger is appearing from chida because of the presence of chidabhasa. The hunger is generated in the mind. The thought of hunger is generated in the mind. Then you say, I am hungry. In your concept, the body is hungry. Body is enlivened by chidabhasa. Okay? So he is really hungry.
So that hunger is a feeling. That yeah. Feeling is also in the mind. And that mind is, that hunger is enlightened or it is reflected or it is illumined by the consciousness.
Yes.
So that is also, what is Shakti only?
That's what I'm saying. Then who is hungry?
So I am hungry, so it is correct only. No, I am is the Shakti.
Ah, but yesterday I am hungry means my body is hungry. My I am hungry is who is Suresh is hungry.
I am enjoying that. Raj is enjoying that.
Raj is enjoying that.
We don't think God is enjoying that.
It's God only, Jagannatha only. That's the naivedya for her.
But the experience of taste and all that is from our body.
Ya Devi.
Sarvabhuteshu.
Buddhi Rupena Samsthita.
Namastase.
Namo Namaha. So who says that
it is tasty?
It is tasty. Buddhi. Who is that Buddhi?
Shakti.
Ya Devi.
Sarvabhuteshu.
Matrarupena Samsthita.
Namastase.
Namastase.
Namo Namaha.
Matru means mother. How is she mother? Mother means love. That means men also have some love, no? I mean, they are not heartless, right? The love, mother appears as love in all of you. So, Shakti. Whatever you are experiencing is Shakti only. Only thing is you are confusing it to you.
I experience by Shakti only.
Who else can you experience? Consciousness only can experience, no?
So, if you are experiencing pain in the body, if you are experiencing any pain or any happiness, whatever, that actual sensation of pain is the mother and being experienced by the mother.
Yes.
Both.
Yes.
Both. So you can remember that.
Only thing is you get a feeling that I am doing it. It's an individual. So there is a pain for you. There is pain for a monkey. There is pain for a dog. The pain is not separate. It's universal. It's universal because it's not you. It is the
mother.
You have to understand the distinction between the individual functionality and universal functionality. Tell me, what is not universal functionality? So you want to taste food when you see Maggie noodle. Dog may want some biscuit. That's individual. That's your individual vasana. Hunger is universal. Thirst is universal. Thinking is universal. Intellect is universal. Are you clear?
About reflective consciousness or the Shakti and the consciousness, actual consciousness, both are different.
Both are same.
Because reflective consciousness is coming from the pure mind or your mind is involved in that. No, it is combination of the.
That's what I'm saying. See, in the pure consciousness and reflective consciousness, one and the same. But reflected consciousness take the form of the mirror. Okay, pure consciousness doesn't take the form of the mirror.
Yes.
Still it is there, like that.
So difference is here?
Difference is in terms of the reflecting place, but the quality is same. Consciousness is same.
Quality is there.
Consciousness
is
same.
Reflected consciousness, the consciousness is always
consciousness there. Doesn't want to become anything else. Consciousness only is taking different forms in the mirror. Okay, consciousness is conscious only.
Consciousness is not taking the form, but it appears like taking the form, but...
That's why it's called Shakti, sir.
So definitely Shakti is different from consciousness.
She is not different. The consciousness is not different. The consciousness which can take different forms is called Shakti. Okay? It's not different. Don't distinguish between the separation. There's no separation between consciousness and Shakti. The closest we can tell about that is Shiva and Shakti, Nataraja. Shakti is not different. When Shiva dances, Shakti. The dance is called Shakti. Now, where is Shakti? Can you separate out Shakti from Shiva?
Dancing Shiva is Shakti.
Like that. You can't separate out. So, like that, the consciousness and Shakti are like that. There's no separation.
Sir, milk is there. In that, if I take water, so the butter and water, both separate is...
But if you cannot separate out like that here. You cannot separate out Shiva and Shakti at all.
You don't know, sir. It is action plus Shiva. It's Shakti.
Correct.
So action, if you take it out.
Yeah, then Shiva will be there, but then you can't, nobody to recognize Shiva. Who will give value to dance? No dancer, yeah. When he gives dance only, he will do the value. Right?
Because it is pure consciousness.
Pure consciousness, nobody there to recognize. Okay, Shakti is there only to recognize Shiva. That's all I'm trying to tell you.
Difference comes only because it's subjective. If it is objective, means...
There's nothing called objective, sir. Everything is subjective only. There's nothing called objective. The objective is also another concept in your subject. Okay, so we will go further. So, is this much clear now? So, you have to understand subtle difference. The I am thought, pure thought is called Jagannatha. No thought called I is Brahman or Shiva. Okay, I am body concept is Jiva. I mean, Jiva identifies the body. Jiva is that I am identify, I am plus the body, plus identification. Okay, the pure I am is Shakti. So now what you have to do, you have to go back. I am body to I am. I am to I. Okay? Like that you have to trace back. Is that clear? So, to give a relationship between the mind and the consciousness, mind is like a ball of iron. It can't give light. But when you put into fire, the iron ball glows like fire. Like that, the mind is a mirror. It cannot glow. Okay? The moment consciousness comes into picture, mind becomes alive. He says, starts thinking, I am. It becomes a single entity. Not two. It acts like a single entity. Are you clear, Arthi?
No, sir.
What is not clear?
I didn't understand this part.
See, the mind is inert. Mind is jada. Is there something called mind?
No,
there's nothing called mind actually.
Mm.
Mind is a concept appearing in consciousness.
Mm.
It's jada.
Thoughts.
It's thought.
Mm.
So on that, the consciousness falls and makes it alive.
Mm.
For example, in your dream, you dreamt that you have Cinderella. Cinderella came to picture.
Mm.
Is there Cinderella? Girl called Cinderella?
No. It's
but Cinderella became alive because of her mind.
Okay.
And she started dancing.
Mm.
But you are sleeping. Right. Like that in consciousness is like analogous something like sleeping.
Mm.
It's at rest. Some movement takes in consciousness. That's called Shakti. But even the movement takes in place, nothing is happening in consciousness. It's purely silent. That's why Narayana is shown as resting in ocean.
Mm.
Narayana is in resting. Okay? So Lakshmi is sitting in the heart of Narayana means she is actually starting creating the world in the form of thoughts in his dream.
No, the
energy is called Shakti.
No, that is when it is expressed.
Mm.
But before expression,
yeah.
It is
expression potential form.
It is there.
Potential form.
Potential
form. Yeah. All powers in the world are power from consciousness only. There's no power other than the balam, balavatamasti, the strength of human being. Everything is consciousness only.
No, when you say nishkriya,
it is nishkriya means consciousness not moving.
Yeah.
Okay? The consciousness not moving.
But it has the ability to
appear to be moving because of concept.
Yeah, appears to be moving, but that appearance also, that Kalpana Shakti is having.
It's having. So otherwise there is no power in the world. No, all powers are coming from consciousness. So mind is like a iron ball. It has no ability to blow. Consciousness is inert. The moment consciousness light falls on it, it's a pure mirror. When the iron ball is put in fire, it starts glowing. Like that, in the presence of consciousness, mind becomes alive. Understand? It's called jiva. And that's what you are. So what happens here? No, we'll wait for that him to come back.
That in mind there is a vritti, whatever a concept what you say, and there is a reflection.
Mm-hmm.
Both are same or different?
No, because of the reflection, the mind gets a vritti.
Because of reflection?
Mm. If there is no reflection, there is no vritti, no thought. Vritti is modification of the mind.
Modification of the mind. So actually when you say, sir, that means like there is something, like this mobile is there, and there is a conscious on that, and it becomes like. So there is maybe there is already an object. That means
there's
that
no object.
Is already there, and when consciousness is shining on that, and it becomes like. So there is a already present. That
there's
present
no object is there. That object is also actually coming from Shakti.
Coming from Shakti and the reflection or the become the light. Both happen simultaneously. At one go. So without consciousness, that vritti can't be there also.
So it's only Shakti who is experiencing the world through different forms.
Shakti is the experience of the world through different forms and attributing it to you.
And we keep thinking that it is us who is experiencing it.
Ah, it's like mother. The mother, your children, no? You hold the hand of the child and make it walk. Ah, my child is walking. Child never walked. You put the food, you put it into the mouth of the child and say, my child is eating. Like that. It's happening. Are we clear now?
So the experiences, the thoughts, everything comes from Shakti.
What is your own, you tell me, then you will find out.
So when we feel hurt.
Is hurt universal or individual?
Individual.
Does he feel hurt?
He also feels.
Does she feel hurt?
Everyone.
Is it individual or universal?
Universal.
Triggering condition is individual, that's what I was. You get hurt when somebody gives a flower to you. Why this fellow is giving flower to me? Somebody gets happy when the same flower is given.
Mm-hmm.
That's individual.
Okay.
Hurt is universal. She also gets hurt, she also gets hurt. That's universal. See, you have to separate out universal from individual. Individual is only some events or triggering conditions which are triggering that. Otherwise, it's all universal only. The universal is mother.
Mm.
You understand? Now we are mixing up the universal and individual. And thinking everything is individual. Like child is walking, child thinks I am walking. It's actually mother is holding the hand and walking.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we go, brother? So, the moment this mirror comes into picture, the mirror sees able to see the body and identify the body, I am body. So now it suddenly feels restricted. Okay? The body is small, but I am is infinite actually. Infinite is put into a box. Like a body. So it's not happy. And it starts seeking happiness here in the world. Divya, are you clear? So this I am is also a special word. I stands for consciousness, am stands for existence. Okay? Consciousness is called chit, am for sat. Sat and chit is called I am. Okay? Sat, Chit, Ananda is called Brahman. So what is the difference? Only Ananda part is missing. So all your life you start seeking Ananda here. Okay? So when you start seeking Ananda here, then liberation. You are seeking Ananda in the appearance. That's called Maya. That's called Samsara. And why you seek Ananda there? Because this infinite light has got confined to one body. Appears to be confined to body. Appears to be. Nothing is happening really. Okay. So, you have to go back from this, finding Ananda here to here, and from here to here. That's called mukti, liberation. Is it clear? Sat, chit is jiva. Ananda is there, it's missing. It's trying to complement the Ananda. How does it complement Ananda? Find the Ananda? Coffee Ananda, TV Ananda, Shadi Ananda, Bachche Ananda. So like that Ananda it keeps on finding some reason. Then, and that I am starts seeking the I, that Ananda becomes infinite.
When I see Ananda, I'm actually seeing bhakti performing there.
Correct. But only thing is, it is limited and finite. Duration is finite. It's time and space limited. Okay. The same Ananda is appearing in a limited way. Sat Chit Ananda only is appearing in a limited window and limited time. But what you are really seeking is infinite. Right? When you drink coffee, Ananda, you drink coffee also, it's coffee Ananda only. I'll never miss it. Morning. All Ananda, all Shakti is Shakti only. But only thing is, you associate the different thing. You associate the body, children and all. It's really coming from Atma. So when you start trying turning inward, you get the, you touch the, connect to the source of Ananda.
It will be consistent.
Not consistent, it is your nature. There's no consistency, means something you'll get. Your nature you can get, you can only recognize.
Right? So is it, you have to say that Atma is enjoying the coffee, I mean we have to somehow reposition.
Right. Atma is only enjoying the coffee, okay, in the form of Shakti. Mm-hmm. But nothing has happened to the Atma, that's, you have to understand.
Yeah, Atma has, yeah.
Atma has not moved an inch from its position, but it has taken the form of Shakti to enjoy the world.
Yeah.
Who is enjoying the world? Atma only, in reality Atma only.
Yeah, yeah.
But in reality it is not done anything. Okay.
Atma is always enjoying, but coffee is limiting that enjoyment.
Atma in the form of Shakti is enjoying. It is like Shekhar in his dream, okay, he became a cowboy. He went to Wild West and enjoyed Wild West. Now who is enjoying really? Is the cowboy or is it Shekhar? Is it both? Shekhar is sleeping on the bed. Like that Atma is not moving anywhere. It's silent. Okay, Atma has a dream form called Shakti. In the dream form, it is created bodies and enjoying. Now, who is enjoying?
Atma is enjoying.
Shiva is silent. He doesn't even know that Shakti is doing all this nonsense. Going around all the whole world.
That is why it is enjoying. When you say it is in bliss, Atma
doesn't doesn't even know that this world is running like this because of Shakti. Shakti has appeared from Shiva. She's running the world.
That is why it is appeared.
She has gone for shopping actually, shopping Ananda everywhere. and this thing, credit card is from Shiva.
And he doesn't know that credit card is gone.
Credit card is gone actually.
He doesn't care
about
it. He doesn't even know also. So, this lady, Shakti, goes all around the world shopping for Ananda. Shops Ananda, children, mall, coffee, tea. Still, it's not satisfied. Does a whole lot of shopping. Ananda. It doesn't end there.
So, it has to come back to Shiva.
This is actually the stories of Shiva. Shakti got angry with Shiva. She went somewhere. All these stories are representation of this. Understand? So now you know who's doing shopping.
Yeah. No, it's not me, it's just... I just want Shakti to be happy.
She is never happy, she is very restless.
So that's her problem.
That's why it's called Shakti. She is very restless. She keeps on shopping, shop hopping also. It doesn't end. So it's like this. Shiva or Sakshi appears on Jiva. Jiva is a combination of Chidabhasa and mind. And that appears as a world. So my question now, your question earlier, is there a world out there or not? The world is appearing from inside out, not outside in. There's no world outside at all.
What we are talking now and all are only imagination.
Inside, in the mind. Okay. So put your other question out of the way. You got a dream. In your dream, with your wife, you went to, Europe trip. Europe trip, right? You purchased a ticket and you went to Europe and you went to your Eiffel Tower and took a selfie. So now, was there an Eiffel Tower? Which came first? Taking a ticket came first or Eiffel Tower came first?
Dream came.
In the dream, your body came and Eiffel Tower came. Like that happened.
The waking consciousness also another dream-like state.
Obviously. That dream is called Maya. Understand? Right now, you are in a dream called Maya. And I am coming here to try to wake you up. wake up. You say, no, this dream is nice.
No, it's not so nice. That's why we are coming.
So, is that much clear now? So, now let me ask you a question. Sir, you are sitting and listening to hear me here. Are you awake or dreaming?
Dreaming.
Depends on which eye you are talking
about. Ah. No, even that ego eye, is it here or is it real or dreaming? Mamata?
Dreaming.
For all you know, you may be sleeping in your bed in the house and dreaming that you are sitting in the class. Can you find out the difference? When you are dreaming, the dream appears to be so real. You will never be able to find out what is waking dream, what is dreaming dream. You understand? The waking experience and dreaming experience are identical in terms of experiencing quality. For example, in waking experience, you go to Africa, Europe. In dream, you go to Europe. Both in the dream, you will never be able to identify it's a dream. In waking state, you will never be able to identify it's a
dream.
It's not a dream. So that's why the quality of waking dream and dreaming dream are same. That's why the name given to waking dream is called Maya.
But the actual dream seems to be very vague and all that. But
that's vague when you got up.
When you were dreaming,
it's not vague at all. When you are dreaming, it's real. Actually, a lot part of dream you forget when you wake up.
I know that there is a birth,
so how do you know that
but
this
in the original that is in the dream actually when actually I am sleeping and dreaming at that moment even in that dream itself I don't have any history.
How do you know? You sat in a plane, you assume that I earned a lot of money to come to a plane ticket. That all assumptions are there. Now also you are sitting here, which means you are working in Chennai and all these things are assumptions only. They say you are taken for granted. You don't even question. In dream also you don't question.
No, here we are questioning. Now I am seeing here
questioning. In your dream, if I come, I will question also. When in your dream, I don't know which dream girl comes. If I come, I will ask the question, same question. Try to get me in your dream rather than some girl. In my dream, anybody comes, I will ask the same question. In my dream, I have no confusion. This is a dream.
Here we feel that we are in control actually. In that dream, actually, we are not in control.
How do you know? In your dream, you don't go for shopping. In dream, you don't go for this thing. You feel as if you are in control. Only after waking, you say you are not in control.
No, after waking up, you'll say, thank God it's a dream. Suppose it's a dream.
But when you dream,
you experience it. It is very surreal.
In dream,
to say, thank God this is a dream when I get up.
And for you may be dreaming that you are like here, sitting here. This may be a dream. And actually, right? You can't understand, you'll never be able to in your life, able to distinguish between what is dream and what is reality.